Welcome back to the last video of this four-part series, where I'll be covering Microsoft Outlook and its improved capabilities when using Copilot, with useful, real-world examples that demonstrate how our clients and our team are using Copilot to assist them in their day-to-day lives. I'm Rick, the CEO at Impact, and we're a technology partner for regulated firms. I've been in the industry for over 10 years now and have over 20 years of experience in the technology space alone. At Impact, we specialize in working with firms to turn their technology from a cost to an asset. Today is another tight demonstration of what's possible with Copilot at a high level, focusing on quick wins for common activities, specifically drafting new emails, replying to existing ones, getting Copilot to review and suggest improvements to said emails, and how to level up searching and preparation for meetings or events. These videos are designed for anyone and everyone who works with Office 365 and is keen to start folding AI into all the things that they do. Copilot can do a lot of advanced stuff too, such as building custom AI assistants and creating fully autonomous AI agents, but that will be a topic for another day. As mentioned in my previous videos, to use Copilot within the Office 365 apps, you need an active Copilot Pro or Copilot for Work license, which can be purchased from Microsoft as a bolt-on to any existing subscription. First things first, with this demonstration, being in a live environment, information will be redacted on screen to maintain the confidentiality of our clients, our team, and our communications. Onto the training. I'll screen share with you now. So Copilot can help you save real time when it comes to drafting emails. I use this feature a lot myself, and the system gets better over time the more you interact with it, as it gets a feel for how you kind of communicate or your style of communication. So when opening a new email, you'll be greeted with a draft with Copilot prompt here. Alternatively, you can press the / key to initiate Copilot manually too. All right, so let's put in our first prompt, draft with Copilot. So let's run that. So this is just the basic prompt, drafting an email. Let's see what comes up. Now you can further modify the prompt to say, separate the email into paragraphs, increase the detail, enhance the urgency, or change the tone to be more formal. To do this, you can either make changes in the box, anything you'd like to change, or you can use any of the sliders to edit the prompt here to make quicker revisions. And there's our new email created from us from a single prompt. Now let's move on to drafting replies. First of all, let's find an email thread we can play around with and click reply. So we found an email thread that we want to work with. Let's go ahead and hit reply here. Now, depending on what the video editors are doing, I'm not sure how much context you'll pull from this, but this is a marketing email from someone who's been persistently reaching out to me. So let's just put a nice, not interested, thank you very much. Again, we've got Copilot, draft with Copilot, or I've used the / here. So, prompt away. Now watch what I do here. Please reference his earlier emails. You don't have to do this. I'm going to talk about this in a moment. So Copilot will apply intelligence to review the thread, then draft a reply that relates directly to the content within the email and its chain, ensuring it addresses the previous correspondence appropriately. Copilot can even sense check your emails for you once you've completed them. Head to the Copilot icon at the top and select Coaching by Copilot. Copilot will provide a list of suggestions, which on review, you can go ahead and apply them to improve the tone, sentiment, and clarity of your emails. This feature helps review and improve emails, ensuring they are professionally drafted. Let's go ahead and apply all suggestions. And there we go, let's go ahead and replace what we've already written. Now, I'm going to leave Outlook for a moment and show you about how Copilot can work with Outlook from a different angle. Where Copilot shines is the search feature. I'm sure most people have found searching for emails within Outlook incredibly inconsistent, and the desired results do not always show up. Annoyingly, Microsoft have moved the Copilot for Work application from the PC to a web app in the summer of 2024. However, recent updates from Microsoft state that they'll be bringing Copilot back as a PC application rather than needing to access it from the web. So, what I'm about to show you for the Copilot web app and the soon-to-be-returned desktop application is the same. Now, you can avoid manual searches in Outlook by using Copilot's advanced search features. For instance, what were the latest updates from Steve? Copilot can use its intelligence to find emails you've described, and the results have references to other emails that it has found, which you can click and open them directly. But I'm not going to do that here, but I'll show you what you need to do. Highlight any reference attached to any bullet. Clicking it will open the email in a new window. You can even ask Copilot to help you prepare for your next meeting. Let's first figure out what meetings I've got next week. Still using the Copilot web app, you can ask Copilot to check your calendar or your meeting notes. Let's go with, what meetings do I have next week? If you also have Copilot enabled in Microsoft Teams calls, Copilot can search and leverage those points of reference too. Let's go with... So this is an example of where you can use Copilot to help you prepare for meetings. Copilot can summarize meetings and the key points without needing to reopen Outlook or Microsoft Teams, and can help you prepare for the next one. Copilot will provide a summary and key points to help you stay organized. That's a wrap for today's tutorial on Microsoft Copilot within Outlook. As mentioned earlier, this is a high-level look at features you can use now. Remember, AI is getting smarter every day, and the possibilities and its potentials are continually increasing. And now that brings us to the end of this four-part series on how to use Copilot within the Office apps. Depending on demand from clients and the public, I'll go on to make complimentary videos covering Microsoft Teams, the Copilot app in more detail, and the OneNote application in the future. If you found this content helpful today, check out our other videos in this four-part series shown on the screen now. Do feel free to DM me for any particular queries or to know more about me and what we do at Impact for our clients. Our website is also in the description, along with any other key links that I've referenced here today. Thanks for watching, and happy copiloting.